Welcome back, Birutir Fore. After Shamne Amra Abar Wazir. So let's go to let me go to Helen. Right. So you mentioned about PR, what it is, how important it is for restaurants. So let's not go back on 20 centuries. How do we think we can share your view with the viewers? What should they do to improve their business then?
From a PR perspective. Yeah. The first thing you need to do is take a long, hard, objective look at what your restaurant is offering the public. If you're still serving the same menus, have the same interiors as you had 10, 20 years ago, you're going to have to objectively decide how to make some changes so that the PR messages that you send out are going to be in context and relevant for today. Because what we were saying earlier about appealing to a younger market,
yes,
these people have traveled all over India. They understand regional food. They can cook it themselves in their own homes.
Yes.
And they expect that level when they go out to eat.
So
what I'm saying is, for a really good, for to bring in a PR agency and say, we want to send out messages to the press and we want to do some charity work to build our reputation in the community, that's all fine. But the first thing a PR will say to you is, we can only reach out to the public and the press on your behalf if you're doing something that's relevant for now. If it's not, let's help you change some of the things that you're doing to make them more contemporary and in context with today.
Well, how do you do a local marketing? Because the majority of the Indian restaurants, apart from within the M25, they are located in remote villages. So therefore, they most probably have that village or a town local within 10, 15 miles radius, 2,000 populations.
Yeah.
I understand all of you are a specialist and everything else, all internet, all digital, all website. But the traditional old way, doing a charity night, raising funds, getting a celebrities in, getting the local mayor in, like in the, getting a disabled fund, Red Cross, you know, drink free, but charge for the food or charge for the drink, food is free. Those was a traditional way of inviting your local community and they would have come in and they would have had the repeat customer. How would you tackle them now? How would you do that?
To be honest, there are two things. Firstly, nothing's changed because if you build likability, that's the biggest barrier to entry for all of your competition. You have to ask yourself as a restaurateur business, what are we doing for our community so that they'll do something back for us? You build likability by doing charity events, by giving to the community that you're in. If you remain insular, you will fall off
the
radar.
Our days, when I was a waiter, Sunday night, nobody used to come to the restaurant, so we used to do Sunday night, once in a month, invite everyone who was coming in and saying, that night, we will be only charging for the drinks and everything else is free. And we used to get 300 to 500 people coming in. And we used to do more business just selling the alcohol, but the food was free.
Exactly.
And every local people would have come in. And I thought that was the best way of marketing for the local.
And nothing's changed. I think those things are still really, really important because engaging with the community is crucial. But you have to look at what you're offering your community in terms of food, drinks, decor. Who's the chef? What are the messages you're giving out? So a good PR strategy will help you make what you're doing more in the context of today. And then when you reach out to your community, offering charity work, bringing in key members of the community for complimentary experiences, yeah, it will be showing them something that they want.
Because you also get a lot of pre-publicity. Local newspapers and everybody else will write a lot of articles about it.
That
you have raised £10,000 for that local charity. The mayor was Mr. Joe Bloke was
right,
there, whoever it is. And it, a lot of free
building
writings.
Your reputation, that's what PR is about. So suggesting charity events, inviting key members of the community, those things all really matter because you will get some more interesting press on the back of it that's about what you're doing in the environment that you live in, rather than just restaurant reviews. But you have to have your offering right. It has to be up to date. You have to be offering, is your menu seasonal and changing? Is your chef on message with
trends? I will
come
back to you soon.
Sure.
Viewers, Amra, we're going to go back to Nadia, one and only. So welcome to the show again. Let me give it to her.
Thank you very much. and welcome to everybody watching at home. Don't forget, you can be a part of this show. All you've got to do is tweet us at Catering Circle with your questions, and you can email us info@chsuk.tv. But I'd like to now call upon stage our special guest, Shetha Pog, the director of Indian Ocean, to talk about his branding. While Shetha Pog comes, once again, don't forget, tweet in your questions at Catering Circle. Welcome to the show, brother.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm from Indian Ocean Catering and Event Management.
And I'd like to ask you today about branding. How do you brand your restaurant?
Well, we don't have to focus internationally. Sorry, am I on the microphone?
Yes, you are.
Sorry. So restaurant is basically based locally. So we focus on local customers. Branding, like I said, we have to create our own brand logo, which doesn't change. Just like Coca-Cola never changed, Pepsi never changed. So our Indian Ocean logo never changed again. That's one thing. Second thing is you have to be specialized in your own dishes as for restaurant. So you have to share with your clients, i.e. customers, what they want. If you have any potential dishes on forthcoming, share the ideas, the ingredients, share their opinion, whether they will like it or not. And then up on your research, create a dish and go for that. Plus, the other thing is to publicize your brand, you can focus local pub, schools, charity event, and these are the strategies that I apply, and it seems to work.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
We've also had some emails in at the Catering Circle. The first email we've had is from Liton Kabir, and I'm going to pass it on to the panel to answer. Liton's asking, I need to invest time and money into marketing and branding. Have you got some simple tips I can do at home? I'll pass that on to Reg.
There's loads of free opportunities for marketing, and you know, completely doesn't cost a single thing, single penny. People can do a simple thing as set up a Facebook page, set up an Instagram page, set up a Twitter page. These are very simple things that you can provide, and you're actually creating yourself an online profile. You're creating yourself an online advertisement, basically, and essentially you're directly available to potential customers. Some things that restaurants don't actually always think about is something like a Google Plus account or a Yelp account. Something like that is very useful when it comes down to people searching for your restaurant. If you don't have a Google Plus account, who are you?
Yeah, you're not known. So thank you so much, Rejak. Moving across to our next guest, Suhail Ahmed Rahman, who's a restaurant owner. My question to you is, do you do loyalty marketing?
My name is Naz Chab, I'm from Temple Lounge.
Sorry, I do apologize. Sorry.
Yeah, so in terms of, what was the question again?
Do you use loyalty marketing?
We do, yeah.
How do you implement it into your
business? Though we operate in high footfall areas, say for instance, in our restaurant in Canary Wharf, we still seek to try and make our customers regulars.
Yeah.
So even if, 60% of our customers are regulars, we will train our staff to try and get to know the customers, get to know what kind of dishes they like. When they come in straight away, we know exactly what they're going to order. In Canary Wharf, you've probably got an hour in lunchtime, which the same customer's going to come in every day. We know exactly what they're going to be ordering. The staff will be trained to get to know them, first name basis, and then also social networking.
Sharina mentioned earlier on that, you know, young adults now love to use social media, whether it's Instagram or Snapchat.
Yeah.
And it's so important to have that right setting and the food presentation. Do you think is most important?
Well, I think it is. What she said is absolutely right about the right setting in terms of getting the target right. And if it is that you're targeting a certain population, a younger crowd, then yeah, they would want to go to somewhere trendier. The food has to look not the same as what the previous generation have been used to. If Instagram and Facebook and everything is true, if 70% of the pictures on there are food, then we can understand, you know, we ourselves actively look for, you know, really good images that the customers themselves upload. And then we will share that and, thank the customer for it. And, you know, that will again...
And again, that's kind of showing loyalty as well, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Thank you so much, Naz Chowdhury, MD of Temple Lounge. Apologies for that earlier on. Once again, do send in your questions. Tweet us at Catering Circle. We have another email for the panel. This question is from Rafiq Hussein, sorry, from Bristol, saying, loving the show and great pointers. How do I compete with chain of restaurants who offer meal deals? I'll pass it across to the panel. Anyone can take that on.
Carry on. You carry on there.
How do you offer a meal deal with the big? I don't believe in much deal, but myself, I believe you provide good quality food. You look after your customer. You give them some incentive. That's the best option.
And Shireen, I know you're like literally itching to say something. What's your opinion on meal deals and how can they compete?
Meal deals are great for those who are looking for a discount, but since 78% of people are looking at reviews on places like TripAdvisor, your immediate thinking process for a marketeer is, how do I get up on the rankings of TripAdvisor? And how to do that is make sure that your quality of food is consistent, even if it's something that isn't something like, you know, Michelin. If the customers like it, then keep making it that way and it will go up in the ranks and your customer service. And if you get the customer service and the product right, people will say they had a great time, even if you're working to build the budget to change your decor. And when you go up in the rankings and you're number one, for example, word of mouth follows, because 78% are looking at the reviews, but then they're talking about the word of mouth as well. And so immediately, you don't really need to do meal deals because people, advocates, are talking about your brand without having to be paid.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Do get those questions coming in today. We've got some great panelists today. Send your questions in. You can tweet in at Catering Circle. Back to the panel.
Thank you. Sasa tumhare se shuru hui abar. Can you tell or share with our viewers that how can we do a visible strategy and PR and marketing strategy to improve the business?
If it's an existing business, and you know, at the moment obviously there is a bit of a crisis in the industry. And if you're looking at avenues on how to...
But again, I know it's not today's subject, but do you think is a crisis there?
Well, that's an actually really interesting point. That there's a semi-crisis, I'd call it. I think, yes, there's been a decline.
The crisis is created by us, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, yes, there's a decline in the Indian restaurant industry, but there's a decline in your traditional curry house industry, not necessarily the Indian restaurant industry. The country haven't fallen out of love of Indian food. The best example of that would be Dishoom restaurant chain. It's all over London. It's been voted the best or the most popular restaurant by Londoners of 2016. Why is that? It's an Indian restaurant, and it's an Indian restaurant that advertises and champions its Indian heritage element of restaurant. It's an authentic restaurant. That's what it's championing. And what is it full of? It's full of the customers that were going to Indian curry houses. It's full of young 20-somethings, 30-somethings, even businessmen in some of their locations that were continuously going to these curry houses back in the 90s and the early 2000s. The reason why Dishoom is succeeding where, say, restaurants in where your traditional curry houses aren't, is Dishoom's established itself a distinctive brand identity. And that's what sets itself apart. You know, they focus their marketing around storytelling. They focused around telling the stories of people in India and in Mumbai and how they've been involved in, you know, what type of food that they eat. They've focused their ideas and their menu on creating authentic Indian cuisine. But really and truly, these are simple things that could have been implemented by the curry house industry, and it hasn't been.
So how can you improve our sales to LS now?
Yeah, I mean, just look at your target market. The market has changed. The choice is more at the moment. There's a range of restaurants, there's a range of cuisines available, and there's a variety of different types of food. Turkish, Mediterranean, Vietnamese, you know, massive variety. How a specific restaurant, a current Indian restaurant who's struggling or who's seeing that they're not getting much business, you identify your local demographic, you develop a campaign, develop a social network platform that can reach out to that demographic, you, if need be, bring in a PR agency, bring in a consultant to support that campaign. You have to spend some money to
generate that. When you look for a PR agency, do you look from City of London when you are in Bristol, or do you look for a local one? How does it work?
I think Helen would be quite helpful in this one, actually, because
it depends what your expectations and ambitions are. If you think your chef is worthy of a Michelin star, you probably want to get the agency with the most clout that you can find, and chances are they'll be in London. Yeah. If you want to be the local, trusted neighbourhood go-to, you're probably better off getting a local PR agency who understands the community that you're in and knows the press, that local press scene. So it actually depends what you as a restaurant have as an ambition.
Thank you, Helen. Lace by Afrika Sishuru Kuriabar. Afrika Branding, Zikaisi. What factors are important in building a brand value?
Brand value, brand doesn't have a value. Brand has unlimited value.
All right.
It doesn't have a limited value.
Okay.
You have to promote your brand so people can always see it, remember it. They always have it in their mind. That's the brand. But after all, you have to have a good quality product, nice brand, who easily people can remember. With the brand, you need a nice slogan, short slogan, so people can think of you all the time. As I say, you don't have to change it regularly. You keep it going and just promote it.
Can you just give us some tips then? To bring more customers in the restaurants, as you are a supplier, a restauranter, and everything else.
I've always said you need a good quality food, good customer relation, the customer service. The customer is a repeat.
ঠিক আছে আমরা সপ্তম আনলাম বাট আমরা তো উই গট টু থিঙ্ক আমরা একটু চিন্তা করতে পারবো ডিফারেন্টলি না ট্রাডিশনাল রেস্টুরেন্টগুলো তো আসলে পুরোনা কাস্টমার কিছু হয় না তারা কিছু রেকমেন্ড করলো দুই চারজন দ্যাটস হ্যাভ ইট ইজ কয়েকটা মেনু দিলে আত করি দ্যাটস হ্যাভ ইট ইজ অনেক অনেক রেস্টুরেন্টের এখন পর্যন্ত ওয়েবসাইট নাই কিছু নাই ইউ নো দ্যাট জাস্ট ডোন্ট হ্যাভ নাথিং নো ফেসবুক পেজ নো কমিউনিকেশন ইটস অল অ্যাবাউট কমিউনিকেটিং উইথ পিপল ইটস অল অ্যাবাউট পুটিং আই new dish chef made something, you know, this is what it is, take a picture, put it on there, this is a special on Sunday roast, for example, or something. We got to have something.
Exactly. You have to produce a nice dish, tasteful dish, colourful, as my colleague said.
It's not necessarily colourful,
you don't use colour, but it has to be good quality food. And it has to be your brand, your own identity, rather than taking from somebody else's.
But again, after nizer product or the bishesh takana, how are you going to sell it to the next person? After the trust bishesh takana, after nizer product or free, after nizer the borosha takana.
So how
are you going to do it? After kila korba, korte parte na. So that prothome to after got tick korte hoybe nani before you go to the PR. After the got tick takana, after the house tick takana, how would you invite the guest? After gora hon carpet nai, after gora gondo gore, after gora khaniya itna time mota. How? After kila korba.
It is the most important. After quality food and service and good apnar maintain korte hobe apnar time maintain korte hobe delivery the delivery maintain korte hobe apnar food or quality is most important, service is most important, your brand is, you have to produce a brand so people remember
it. Apnar eta mone korena je ekhon apnar jokhon ekta business plan koren, when we have a business plan apnar ekta vision thakte hobe and vision like a mission thakte hobe, this is the way I'm going to deliver this, this is the PR company, this is how I'm going to launch the product. When Helen said that launching is very important, amra omulan kormo othoba a traditional 20 bochor purana restaurant ase, a second generation came in, so he's going to have a bit of a touch up, change over. A lot of people, you know, like a bit of a simple color, they don't like any more boxes, they don't like any more trees, they don't like any more Taj Mahal anymore inside.
No, it's all, you know, plain and simple.
Because the Taj Mahal is not dream to anyone, you just Google it, it comes up.
And that.
Right, Africa Centre for A. Let me go to G. I'm going to come to you. What can a restaurant do promote his business without having to hire a PR agency?
Oh my God, Helen's looking over at me. So I'll say it in Bengali.
Yeah, please do. Say it in English.
Well, I won't.
There's no one answer.
No, I'm joking. I will say it in English and some in Bengali. Amra manushrum aze, ek thinking process aze, marketing expensive. Actually, marketing expensive now. If you know what you're doing, if you know your customers, a lot of the PR and marketing you do is free. Like Helen said, well, obviously, PR isn't free because you need some expertise there. And and what Reg said
but
in terms
can,
of...
But you can hire a lot of PR company with result as well, you know?
No, they won't.
It doesn't cost millions of pounds in the beginning.
No, it doesn't cost, but you have to look at what they're what they're giving you. You know, some of the services you may not need.
But don't you think we have to think outside the box? We're thinking within the box. We've got to get outside the box.
Yeah, but just before we think out of the box, I just want to highlight, when you say, what can we do for free? There are so many things that actually very powerful things that you can do. So as I mentioned earlier, 78% of people are looking on reviews. Your number one thing to do before you talk about marketing, before you talk about tidying up your branding is, do you know who you're providing for? If you are in, Surrey, and you've got people with 2.4 children, lots of money, you're not going to give them an offering which is cheap as chips. And so you have to know, if you are 90% white community, you're not going to give them, shatkara, whatever, all the time. You know, you have to know what dish is going to work for which customer. Once you decide that, then you sort out your brand. You're going to then do your direct marketing, which is your leaflets, your menu, which is in line with your brand. And then you're going to do customer service to do your TripAdvisor. And then you're going to do the social media and your PR.
Thank you. I'm going to come back to you. Lace by Amra, Bujan Gestry Bidadi Mutarmaja Afnaja, but after 30 seconds number of views, already Kitahoi Basket program on Lagaske, Kitahur Tatarakokose.
Thank you very much, viewers. Afnara, I'm sure from aware, Afnara quality maintained Horba. Discount doesn't normally count. Afnara unnecessary spend Horbana, Afnara customer look after Horba, Afnara brand promote for Afnara the logo, Afnara. Promote Horoka, Afnar customer, Afnar Sinto, it Afnar Kara.
That's why, thank you. Thank you. Chachi, you got to say something in 30 seconds. We're going to get two more new guests. So, what would you like to say on today's program? How do they improve on PR 10 seconds, on marketing PR 10 seconds, and branding 10 seconds? All yours.
I think the most important thing is don't be scared about the notion of PR and marketing. It's actually very, very simple elements that we've discussed that you can do. And when it comes down to trying to generate new business, think, don't necessarily follow the crowd. Look at what you can do that's unique and innovative of yourself. It's one of the reasons why some of the best restaurants in London, in the world, work. So don't always follow what everyone else is doing. Develop your own identity.
Thank you. Viewers, I'm ready to chat to you. Jaimu, I'm ready to join you. Get two join guests. Lo, you have to come in front of us. Television is in front of us. I'm ready to come in front of us. So let's go for a break. Good evening, Assalamu alaikum. Asha kori apnara shob television samne bala achen. Audience jara invited tara shobre salam. Asha kori bala achen bala thakati amra shob shomoy chai. Ajke as usual catering circle apnara shobre amontron, but tar age amra goto episode o kito hoyeche amra apnar loge share korechi. Let's go and see a small video clip last episode. Thank you.
What is online ordering?
Internet er byabohar barar karone online ordering restaurant ebong takeaway owner der
obviously you have to market that. I'm saving money on the process. Obviously I'm not using Just Eat, I'm using my own website, so my brand awareness is there.
Rather than having to fund costs to promote these kind of online ordering that we're doing by the
be it with a third party or ourselves. I think we can, this social media doesn't cost a lot if you interact within yourself.
I'm on a responsive website for it. It's a shop got a device, Shundo have a play. Our mobile play korbe, at the same time, our desktop play korbe.
We have to be very realistic and actually go for solutions that have long-term plans, not just short-term goals.
My mom used to read letters, right? Before, used to write letters. Now she gets things done on WhatsApp, right? No one ever taught me how to use an iPhone, right? All you got to do is just make your first love, because the business you have really worked for, it shouldn't just give you a living, it should give you a life.
So you need to look at maintaining the identity, reliability of service, helping, guiding. That's the main one.
Online company gula kun dhoroner platform tara use kore customer ami oi jinishta ami shikhar chesta korbo.
Ultimately, what's really important is not so much whether you're on a fixed price or on a commission, but whether the overall cost is delivering you value for money and it's affordable.
Tole ei je commission ta ami jodi amar customer ke aro ektu komaiyao dei, asha kori amar customer priye ache.
You got to work for it. There is no easy way of saving cost. Firstly, apnar jodi nijer brand koren and nobody knows about it, you won't get any order, which means there is nothing to save. Order fight really, either you have to invest on a third party company to do marketing, and then it's an easy case of marketing, you go free as a. So there's so many ways. It's basically to really save cost, you've got to invest and get your control. You've got to be a smart businessman.
Thank you.
গত এপিসোডে আপনারা দেখলাম, আপনারা ক্লিপ দেখলেন গত এপিসোডের। আজকের সাবজেক্ট পিয়ার মার্কেটিং এবং ব্র্যান্ডিংয়ের উপরে। সো লেটস গো অ্যান্ড সি অ্যানাদার ভিডিও ক্লিপ। আপনারা যারা অডিয়েন্স সকল আছেন তারা আমরা লোকে দেখুক। সো লেটস গো অ্যান্ড সি ইট। থ্যাংক ইউ।
এপিসোড 8 পিআর মার্কেটিং এন্ড ব্র্যান্ডিং, ফাইন্ডিং আউট হাউ উই ক্যান রিব্র্যান্ড দ্য কেটারিং সেক্টর এন্ড শোকেস সাম গুড এক্সাম্পলস অফ সাকসেসফুল বিজনেসেস। ইজ ইয়োর রেস্টুরেন্ট বিজনেস ফেইলিং? It may be your PR, marketing, and branding. Let's watch what people had to say during our roadshow.
Please don't get involved with the commission payment to the online marketing. Make it your branding.
We need to get our branding right, our marketing right, our PR right.
Please give branding and marketing a serious consideration in your business.
There are aspects to your business, things like antioxidants, peppers are. Other businesses are using these aspects of your business to promote their own food.
What do I need to do? Use public relations and social media to bring in new customers. Can't afford a PR firm? Obtain ideas from their blogs and implement it yourself. Why brand building is important? Branding is fundamental. Branding is basic. Branding is essential. Building brands builds incredible value for restaurants. Branding is where you start. Marketing as a function supports the brand. Top tips to perfect your brand. If you want to beat your competition, establish an uplifting brand. But don't try to establish a brand based on your desire to beat your competition. Pick one message, stick with it for at least a year if it appears promising, and then try another. But you can't try several at once or switch every few months. Use simple words and be consistent with it. Check out the competition from time to time. Make sure your brand's message is known and understood by all the people in the organisation, from the top level managers down to the front desk staff. People will say good things about you when A, you have a great product, and B, consumers will market for you. Brands are built on what people are saying about you, not what you're saying about yourself. Marketing should be a very high priority. You need to differentiate yourself from your competitors and create a unique selling proposition. Your customers spend more time looking for restaurants on the web. Can hungry customers find your restaurant today? Restaurants dominate the local search and mobile landscape. 24% people search on the PC or laptop, 30% on mobile phones, and 28% on tablets. When conducting specific business searches, 67% consumers look for restaurants. Do you have a website to begin with? Is your website visible and searchable online? Customers use their mobile devices when researching about restaurants. 93% to find a restaurant location, 95% to find restaurant phone numbers, 90% to check the menu, 93% to check hours, 78% to find discounts, 78% to check reviews. Is your restaurant mobile friendly? Can your restaurants be found in a local listings? Customers order food using the mobile devices. 64% consumers look to complete their purchase within an hour. Factors that make consumers more likely to order are discounts, loyalty points, ease of ordering, delivery alerts, ease of finding restaurants, remember past orders, on-time delivery guarantee, and remember credit card for ease of checkout. Some of the most important tools that you can use to bring quality clients to your restaurants are mobile marketing, email marketing, SMS marketing. Marketing is the lifeblood of your business.
বিয়সকল আপনারা একটা ছোট ডকুমেন্টারি ক্লিপ দেখলাম আমার লগে আইওকে আজকের প্রোগ্রামের যারা গেস্ট হল আছেন তার লগে ফরিসে করে দেই তারপরে আমরা আর একটু সামনের দিকে যাই মিসে লেটস স্টার্ট ফ্রম মাই রাইট গুড ইভিনিং হেলেন হাউ আর ইউ
গুড ইভিনিং আই এম ফাইন থ্যাংক ইউ
বিয়সকল আমরা লগে আছেন হেলেন হোকিন ম্যানেজিং পার্টনার্স এন্ড গোল্ডবোর্ন নাশ পিয়ার ইউ ওয়ার্ক উইথ দ্য কোম্পানি
থ্যাংক ইউ আই ওন দ্য কোম্পানি
ইউ ওন দ্য কোম্পানি ওয়েলকাম টু দ্য শো
বিয়সকল
আমরা আমার আরেকজন গেস্ট আছেন হাতুর ডানে আপনারা চিনুন নাসিনলে এখন চিনবা রেজাউল হক আমরা তাহলে রেজ হক দেখবো পিআর কনসালটেন্স এন্ড ইভেন্ট প্রডিউসার ওয়েলকাম টু দ্য শো ভিউ যখন আমার হাতুর বাম থেকে শুরু আবার শেরিনা আলী চার্টার্ড
মার্কেটার I'm fine, thank you.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Viewers, our final guest for this panel, Mohammed Abdullais, MD Euro-Asia Food Service. Welcome to the show. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Palasunibai.
Alhamdulillah.
Thank you. Viewers, last year, program was actually catering circle shop show. We have a shabta pori pori after a shamne topic. Last topic very simple. বাফতা দখলে যখন শুরু করছিল 20th century মার্কেটিং আসলে ট্র্যাডিশনাল মার্কেটিং পিয়ার মার্কেটিং যে সব কিছু হয়েছিল ট্র্যাডিশনাল ওয়ে কিছু মেনু ড্রপ করা কিছু মানুষের দাওয়াত দেওয়া হয়তো লেট 20th century আপনারা কিছু কিছু চ্যারিটি করতা কিছু কিছু ব্র্যান্ডিং করতা লোকাল মানুষের ডাকিয়ে আনতা বাট ওয়ার্ল্ড হ্যাজ মুভড অন এখন দেখা যায় যে আগামী 10 বছর পরে হয়তো ট্যাক্সি ড্রাইভার রাস্তার থাকতো না বিকজ এখন দেখা যায় যে ড্রাইভারলেস কার বাড়িয়ে গেছে অলরেডি স্টার্টেড ইন আমেরিকা অলরেডি স্টার্টেড ইন সিঙ্গাপুর ড্রাইভলেস গাড়ি হল আসলে কিন্তু আমরা টেকনোলজির লোকে আমরা কিন্তু আপ টু ডেট করতাম পারছি না আমরা সেলফে আমরা কিন্তু আসলে 20th century থেকে বাপদাদার লেগেসি যেটা আছে যারা শুরু করছিল তারা এটা কিন্তু আমরা দৌড়িয়ে রাখতাম পারছি না আমরা আসলে নেক্সট টু নেইবরে ব্লেম করাম অমুকরে ব্লেম করাম মার্কেটের ব্লেম করাম আসলে আসলে কিন্তু আমরা সব দিকে খালি ব্লেম করা তো থাকবো না আসলে আমরা সেলফে আপডেট করতাম হইব আমরা আর একটু এডুকেট করতে হইব আমরা সেলফে সোসাইটির লোকে ব্যালেন্স করতে হইব মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্টলি আপনারা প্রত্যেক মানুষের মোবাইল ফোনে হান্ড্রেডস অফ রেস্টুরেন্টস এখন দে হ্যাভ মোর চয়েসেস তারা মোবাইল ফোন অন করলেই আপনার একশো হয়তো আমি একটু কম বলি যে হাজার হাজার রেস্টুরেন্ট ডিফেন্স আপনারা কিলা দেখবা, আসলে কি তা আমরা যারা রেস্টুরেন্টরা আসুন তারা কি তা আসলে আপডেট করতে পারছেন তারা সেলফের তারার লগে? বাট আমরা এইগুলো নিয়ে আজকে আমরা এক্সপার্ট প্যানেলিস্টও আছেন তারার লগে আমরা একটু আলাপ করবো, আপনারা আমার লগে সহযোগিতা করবা, আপনারা আমরা অ্যাডভাইস করার লাগে আজকের প্রোগ্রামটা বা কোনো প্রোগ্রামই আমরা করি না, আপনার লগে আমরা শেয়ার করতাম চাই যে আসলে ওয়ার্ল্ড কিতা ওর আসলে আমরা টেকনোলজির লোকে অ্যাডভান্স আছে কিনা না। লেটস গো অ্যান্ড ফাইন্ড আউট। হ্যালো, আই এম গোইং টু স্টার্ট ফ্রম ইউ, সরি আই হ্যাড টু স্পিক ইন বেঙ্গলি। হোয়াট ইজ পিআর?
পিআর অর পাবলিক রিলেশনস ইজ দ্য ওয়ে আ রেস্টুরেন্ট কমিউনিকেটস ইটস মেসেজেস, ওয়েদার থ্রু দ্য মিডিয়া অর ডাইরেক্ট টু ইটস কাস্টমার্স এন্ড পটেনশিয়াল কাস্টমার্স। ইটস দ্য ওয়ে ইউ কমিউনিকেট, ইউ সেন্ড আউট মেসেজেস, ইউ ক্রিয়েট কি মেসেজেস এন্ড ইউ সেন্ড দেম আউট থ্রু দ্য মিডিয়া or direct through your community.
How important it is.
It's absolutely crucial. I don't think a business can function without PR. It has to be an integral part of a business plan. It's mostly important when a business is first starting out. A launch of a new restaurant without PR is unthinkable. A PR agency can help you reach your market very, very quickly. You couldn't do that in a year yourself as a restaurateur. Second instance when you really need PR is when you've been around for a while and maybe you've become a bit lackluster. So you can engage the assistance of a PR agency to help you create exciting new messages to send out to your community and to the press about what you're doing.
Are you saying that managing a reputation and building a good relationship with client base and inviting them, is that simpler way of saying a PR? Or
by engaging a PR agency, you'll be working to build a reputation, to grow a reputation with your community and with the press.
Thank you, I'll come back to you. Thank you. Rez, simple. A common thing in Bangladeshi market, when a restaurant is not doing well, where do we hit first? We hit in the marketing. We stop sending menus. We can't afford it anymore.
Yeah.
Is it a right thing or a wrong thing?
No, I think that in this day and age, there's so many avenues available to a restaurateur, to a business, in order to actually generate additional custom. So for example, you know, the old school style of, oh, let's send out menus, or even let's take out an advert in the local paper. These are also avenues that work. It just depends.
Do people use any more local paper?
I do. I don't know about you, but I certainly look at the
local
paper.
But if I want to go to a restaurant, would I go to a local newspaper and go through 30 pages and 20 pages? I don't think I got the time anymore.
Exactly.
But would you go?
I think that's one of the reasons why some PRs would always encourage people, instead of maybe spending £500 to £1,000 on an advertising campaign in a paper, you cannot look at the option of maybe doing a PR campaign. And that would involve a range of things.
Go back to slightly behind. From the 20th century on 21st century, how the marketing has changed, you think?
Massively, obviously, with the advances of technology, with the variety of social media that's available to our disposal, and also the type of the way behaviours of customers has changed. It's changed massively. It's not necessarily face-to-face marketing anymore. It's very digital. It's very now. I want things right away. It's very instantaneous. So the notion of marketing isn't just, oh, you know, let's send out flyers. You know, people want to see some of the social elements right away.
When we went to university, we learned two types of marketing. One is the long term and one is the short term. What is a long term and what is a short term to your view?
Long term is your long term strategy, maybe your brand identity. Certainly as a PR, I'd always look to develop an identity for a specific brand. If it's a restaurant, you look at how you're going to build a brand over the years. Well, how do you want your customers to view your brand? Short term, you look at instant fixes.
But why Bangladeshi restaurant has failed on branding?
I think also it's education. I think a lot of the older restaurant owners are not so appreciative of what PR can generate for them, and they may discount the values of PR. It's also spending money, so sometimes people don't like to spend extra money. So that's the problem. I don't like these cliche sayings, but you have to speculate, you know, to accumulate. So and it does generate significant.
Are you trying to say you have to spend money to make money?
Of course, I think that's part and parcel of business, isn't it?
So I'll come back to you again. Thank you. Right, after I can say. Lace by Dathamina, Apple by Dathamina.
Lace by
Dathamina. After I guess a brand, what is brand?
Brand is a name, is a sign, identity.
Apni mone koren je customer choice thake brand er upore and it plays a large part in the marketing as well if you have a right brand.
You have, of course, the brand, if you look at
আমরা কোকোকোলা যাওয়ার হাম নাই ম্যাকডোনাল্ডস যাওয়ার হাম নাই কিউএফসি যাওয়ার হাম নাই লেটস স্টিক টু
লেটস স্টিক টু ইন্ডিয়ান রেস্টুরেন্ট
বোম্বে প্যালেস বোম্বে ব্রাসারি দোজ
আর দোজ আর দ্য প্রোডাক্ট বিকজ দে হ্যাভ ব্র্যান্ড দে হ্যাভ নেম দ্য ব্র্যান্ড ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট ফর আওয়ার মার্কেটিং এসপেশালি উইথ ইনক্লুডিং দ্য ব্র্যান্ড
When I was a student, I used to work in Indian restaurant. I used to serve majority American customers in Bombay Palace and Bombay Brasserie. They used to book the table from Canada, America, and everywhere else because they had the brand. Well, in Edgeway Road, that part of Western most probably had 500 Bangladeshi restaurants, but people used to come from there to that specific restaurant. I'm talking 28 years ago, 27 years ago. But why do you think the Indian owners was successful 28 years ago on branding, but the Bangladeshi restaurant was not successful?
Well, they were not promoting their brand. They didn't stick with the brand. They have keep changing the restaurants.
আমরা বাংলায় মতে কি তার লাগি মনে করেন তারা ফেল করছেন খোকাসেন
No, there are.
Was it lack of business knowledge? Was it lack of visions? Was it because Amra
promotion? Shabnotik promotion, quality, maintaining the product. Quality food is most important in the restaurant. Branding, I used to have a very good restaurant. I used to get booking from America at a place called Blue Cobra, if you ever heard of it. That was a brand itself.
I mean, branding also helped with your employers. Because if you want a good staff, if they see that restaurant's got a brand and they think that got a future, you will get the best of the best in
best
there.
You
will get the customer, you will get stakeholders, partners, all. If a Bombay Palace or Bombay Brasserie 20 years ago wanted to say, I'm going to bring two partners, I think 50 of them will queue up with bags of cash money. But if you now go to a traditional restaurant who hasn't got a good brand, and if he's suffering for money, he wouldn't get somebody to come and invest money on him, is it?
No, he wouldn't.
So why are we failing? Kene amra fail koram?
Amra promote koram na. Amra lack of the bhai jeta hoisen je we are not promoting, we are not investing to promote our product, promote our brand. It is lacking. The marketing is very important. At the same time, you have to keep up with your quality with the brand as well. Brand to
right. So apnar kache amra jani apni nijer branding er lagi ki ta korchen apnar nijer
byabsha ami branding er lagi ami promotional product branding kori. I have my own branded product as a wholesaler. Amar ami onno customer lagi ami branding kori, including takeaway bags, wet towels, chocolates to their name, so they promote their brand.
But you're promoting yourself to the restaurant.
I'm not promoting
to
the restaurant. No, I'm not promoting. The restaurant has to promote themselves. They have to promote their brand to promote their promotional to promote their brand. It's not my brand I'm promoting. A brand for the customers to promote themselves, to promote their business.
Who would you say in the Bangladeshi sector or Indian restaurant sector? Name me one or two brand of a restaurant. In your opinions, obviously.
In my opinion, Leraj, Malik's, people like them, Cinnamon Tree, they have a brand.
Do they have 10 branches? Do they send 5 franchises, or do they just have
Malik's
one restaurant?
Malik's have four branch, and which is they have a good name, good brand, good quality restaurant.
Okay, so there are a few brands around.
There are a few brands around.
Okay, all right. Let me go to my next guest. What is marketing?
What is marketing? Marketing is giving out your message. What do you stand for? What your key messages are through various channels that your customers use. So marketing can be direct marketing, which is leaflets, which somebody who is in an environment where there are lots of tourists, that's very useful. If you're trying to target the younger market, that would have to be social media. So it's the channels to get to your customer, to get your message across.
Why are we failing to invite the young customer? When I'm saying young, I'm not talking 10 years old. Let's say 18 to 40 years, because the Indian restaurants lover or curry lover are not in that age group. Are we not marketing enough? Are we not doing enough with them?
See, before you start marketing, you have to understand your customer and how they work and what their behavior is. And the problem with Bengali restaurateurs is they're not talking to their customers. They don't know what they're liking, what their favorite flavors are. They don't know what the fashion they follow are. So when they have a style of restaurant, whether it's modern, whether it's traditional, they want to give that to the customer. But you can't work like that. People are very fussy. People look on the internet. They like to choose. They like to have an educated decision. So they like one style of trend, and they want to look for the restaurant. Now, when they come to your restaurant, how are you marketing to them? They're not reading the newspaper. The newspaper is for the older market, 45 plus. They are all on Snapchat, Twitter, social media, and that's where they find out what's fashionable. That's where they find out what's the cool place to go. That's where they find out where your discounts are. And then they look at your website and they look for special offers, etc., because they haven't got money. They want to come in a group. And then they find that your website has all these music and all sorts, and it's hard to use. It's not mobile friendly. How are they going to make a decision? And when they go there, they want to be seen. They want to take an Instagram shot saying, oh, look, I'm here. But they don't want to go in a 1970s restaurant, or they want to take a picture of their food. About 70% of pictures on Instagram are food related. They don't want to take a picture of some brown stuff on a yellow plate, for example. They want to take a picture of very pretty positioning. Yeah. So it's either, or if your food is tasty and it doesn't look so great, they want to take a picture of where they are, the cool place. So the marketing isn't just what you do, the channels. It's about your customer service. It's about the atmosphere, and it's about how you're going to attract them.
So building a trust with your customer as well.
Not just building a trust, understanding them, how they decide. We are Bengalis. We decide a place because of what our counterparts like. We also want to go to a place. Is it halal? You know, this is how we think. We have to understand how they think.
I'll come back to you and I'll find out how the Turkish is doing now.
Okay.
Because we have to go to a short break. After the break, we'll come back and continue. Amra Luge Thakba. So let's go for a break. Thank you. Viewers, welcome back. Birotir pore apnara samne amra abaro hazir. Amra ekhon dujon notun guest loye eshi Catering Circle. Ajker subject jara age ekhonoi amra loke join korchen jara age theke nai PR marketing ebong branding. So let's go and see amra loke khe aisen notun viewers ko amra ager dujon guest kesen ekhon amra notun ekjon guest aisen amar hatur bame ebong tan hatur bame amra Dulumia. Welcome to the show, Dulu bhai.
Assalamualaikum.
Welcome to the show. Palasuni.
Alhamdulillah.
Thank you. Dulu bhai, CEO of Bada Creative. Thank you. So, Abdul Shahid bhai, welcome to the show. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you. Walaikum assalam.
Balasuni bhai.
Alhamdulillah.
Thank you. Marketing Director, Chef Online. Thank you. Viewers, I'm going to talk to you about the next question. I'm going to talk to you about the next question. So, let's go. Using social media, current trend, pregnant, whatever it is, it's on social media before anybody else, you know. Even if they fancy anyone, they've seen someone, or photo their clothes, it's on social media. It's just a communication way, and it's the cheapest way. It's just bang. This is the 21st century for you. So where are we going? This declining industry of an Indian restaurant selling chicken tikka masala seems to be failing on that subject. Why do you think we are failing on that?
I think coming from a digital marketing background, a lot of our traditional Indian restaurants are failing on their communication, whereas I feel that there is a massive gap in the market from going back to how it was in the 70s.
I want to know more about failing. Why do you think they're failing?
I think their presence on digital is not enough where it should be today. I mean, if we were...
But Tell me, these guys are not international brand. They are local, Fred in a shed. They're in the Kukum village. I used to work in a restaurant in Kukum Tandoori, Kukum village. Their whole village within 10 miles, there was not 3,000 people there. Most probably today there are 6,000 people. Why is so important all these things?
I mean, digital has grown massively.
Would I go from London to Kukum to eat? One and a half hours drive?
It depends. I mean, if they provide a quality service and food, I mean, you know.
Would people go 2 hours?
I would. I've been to crazy place to eat purely because of the service and taste. There is a lot of restaurants out there trying to go to a certain extent on digital, but I think this is where digital expert like ourselves and other digital experts, where they turn to sort of revamp the digital strategy to sort of take their content to the next level. I mean, everybody in this day and age is on Instagram or on Twitter or on Facebook. And there's a purpose behind it where it doesn't cost a lot of money to spread the word. It doesn't cost a lot of money to grow a brand identity and acquisition on an online sort of presence. So I think going back to your question, a lot of our Indian local restaurants are lacking on their communication, on their digital strategy as a whole.
So what would be tips from you? What do you think we should do? Do you think every restaurant should have a Facebook page?
I think every restaurant, yes. I strongly recommend every restaurant to have a look at their social media strategy. They should have a look at to see if they don't have a Facebook. I strongly recommend that they do have a Facebook, because in this day and age, everybody is on Facebook. And
I have a text message service. I hate that. Every day I get about 10 offers from 10 different people. Some of them even
PPI
even
insurance.
PPI insurance. Some of them, even if you press it, it costs you money. Do you recommend people should send text messages saying, tonight chicken tikka masala is half price. If you buy one, you get the chicken duck free, you know, whatever it is.
I guess maybe text message is not being used as
special offers.
I mean, communication, again, it's content. You know, there's nothing wrong with pushing out
happy hours
or sort of you know, whatever they want to call it. But I mean, it's again communication, and if they're passing across the right message to their consumer.
All right, let me ask you a benefit. Where do you think a benefit will be from a Facebook page? What benefits?
Because
we need to tell our viewers some benefits.
They could acquire most definitely more customers, because hashtag itself works quite well. Depending on a location based on Facebook, if it's trending and if there is a lot of people that's talking or hashtagging along these keywords, then they are acquiring more customers or interest. Then again, it needs to be looked at their digital strategy as a whole to see where they are, if they have a website, if they have a brand identity in place, if they have the social media activity live and feed live. So, yeah, I mean.
So, for example, but Facebook also can shut their business in case they do a little mistake.
I doubt it very much. I mean, they've obviously come quite far down. But I mean, Facebook is, 10 years ago, a lot of business wasn't relying on Facebook. But in this day and age, you could only spend a couple of pounds and have a sponsored advert to generate more traffic to your restaurant or to your brand or to your website.
Right, Dhruvay, let me come back to you again. Thank you. Shahid Bhai, after to Chef Online on Logayasu, Marketing Director. After opinion, after synthetic is social networking, khototuku effective for amra restaurant in this age, digital age.
First of all, assalamu alaikum to all your viewers, and thank you for inviting me to the show. And my background, I'm a restaurateur by trade, and social marketing. I mean, obviously, when our forefathers started this trade, I'm the third generation in it, there wasn't any technology. We're in the digital world now, so digital marketing is very important. So we need to use these tools, the resources, like SMM, social market media, a search engine optimization, to the best of our benefit, because we are in a densely competitive market. So we can't just say, yes, sir, no, sir, please, sir, thank you, good night, look forward to see you again. We need to expand our horizons and use the social media through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, but and what's available.
Chad, but don't you think this is, obviously, we can't blame them, because what happened is, when I came to Britain, and in 88. In 1992, I had a mobile phone, and my mobile phone was a brick phone, a Motorola.
Remember those ones?
So it's only 25 years ago. If you really think the technology going advances within last 20 years, it's not before that. But the Indian restaurant has been here near enough hundreds of years. You know, 70 years definitely we can prove with track records. But so those days there was no need for any of this. It's now the 21st century we need it. I remember I had to put an aerial on in 1994 to speak to someone on a mobile phone. You had to put a briefcase there and get your antenna up before you get a signal anywhere else. It's recent, you know, it's as only 23 years ago. So last 15 years, most probably the technology gone advanced. But most probably we haven't updated ourselves and we haven't changed with it. The world has changed. And that could be the only thing we can say to our viewers or the restaurateurs that we haven't changed ourselves. But now what can they do to change themselves? Let's go to this one.
Well, first of all, I think a lot of the restaurateurs are still within their eggshell, sorry to say, you know, not in a negative way, but they are very successful themselves. And I think where we tend to overlook is we're doing great business. End of the week, we're accumulating good cash and we're putting it in our back pocket and we think that's profit. But really, if we do our due diligence...
Actually, I know it's nothing to do with this today's program, yeah, but this industry has got money. If you think about it, how much a bag of potato cost? £5.
Mm. But what
how
I'm trying
portion
to
of Bumbo potato can you sell? You can make over 700 quid.
Of course, but what I'm trying to say is sometimes when you see the cash coming in, you forget that you are not with the competition market. And to stay in touch, of course, there's people like you.
Don't you think, Shahid Bhai, we are not taking professional advice. The whole night we've been talking about, last hour and a half we're talking about, we need to get outside people come in and get people to see you are in the business. You need somebody from on the business, from the top, and come in and say, I think that's what you should do. I think this is how it should go. This is how it should be done. And it's not going to cost millions of pounds.
No, I mean, it starts within your restaurant. You should have a growth strategy in place. You should have a perception where you want to be in 5 years' time, where you want to be 10 years' time. You should know what tools to use to your disposable. And unfortunately, that's where we make the errors. Like I said, we are making money and we forget that these tools are also important to assist us to be where we want to be in 5 years and 10 years' time. And therefore, programs like this, the PR agencies, we need to actually educate our restaurateurs that they are available. Use them as a tool for your own enhancement, for your own prosperity. And we need a lot of education in our industry.
Okay. Let me ask you a technical question. How does customer relation management, CRM, or ecosystems help restaurants grow their revenue?
Well, it's a tool that helps you to analyze your customer, their preferences, their choices, who they are, how long they've been with you. And not only that, when you look at it at the wider scale, you can see exactly how many chicken tikka masalas you're selling, what your best sellers are, what are not. That will help you create your new menus, have your brand identity, and keep in line with what the customer's perception is, what they want from you. So the CRM system works greatly to understand your customer needs. And if you can understand that, you can also help to develop and grow your business.
Fair enough, fair enough. But also, do you think they can save some money on the shoppings?
Well, the way I see it, you know, I've got several restaurants. I never look to give meal deals, discounts, because
Why not?
Because my customers...
Why you can't give people a deal?
As long as you give a good service, you provide the right ambience, the right restaurant, quality food, people are not looking for discounts because it's not McDonald's or Burger King.
Did you buy it on a summer sale?
I'll be giving away too much personal information.
But what happened? People do wait for a summer sale and a winter sale. It's a traditional. Why we can't give once in a month, once in a few months, a good deal in a restaurant? But why not?
I've been brought up to understand that eating out is a luxury product.
Even Ritz does that, you know, does a good deal, package deal, you know. It does. Package deal. When you go three people, four people, there is deals. You go to the website and you do.
But,
you
know, it's your identity. Going back to brand identity. Do you want to see yourself as giving discounts? If you are, then you have to stick to that format.
Well, why don't you do it a different way? Why don't you say that this week's sales, 10% of the proceed of the sales will go to Red Cross charity or whatever it is?
Yeah, well, that's, we already do that.
Unprecedented, the British citizens here, they are the biggest donor in the world. And if they know that their 10% of proceed of their sale going to a genuine cause, you most probably will have a lot of revenue coming through through the business.
You know, when we build our brand identity, we are doing charity events in the restaurants. We are sponsoring local cricket teams, local football clubs. So we're already doing that. We're giving something back to the community because, you know, our market segment, especially where I am in the countryside, is within a certain radius. You know, I can't attract customers from London. But by doing that successfully,
well, these brothers say they drive two hours, 3 hours, but they're most probably within a 1% or 2%, not going to be 97%, are they? But anyway, I'll come back to you later. Shaina, let's. Sharina.
Yeah.
Right, let me just go to you then. I'll come back to you. Right, marketings. Let's go back to you again. I know we said that before I went to the break. What is a content marketing? What does that mean? I don't know. Teach me.
Content marketing is quite simple. It's providing, the old style of marketing was, this is where we are, come and enjoy our food, we've got some great offers. Content marketing is marketing in a more subtle way. So say you're using Facebook, say you're using Twitter, whatever, or your website. I'll use Facebook as an example. You're not just saying, this is what we've got to offer, we've got a great deal. You're saying, we are experts in British Bangladeshi food. Did you know Bangladesh is about this? It's about giving the customer information that is indirectly linked to the product to make you look like the expert and to give them interesting information that they buy into your brand. They have an emotional relationship with your brand. And if you're doing that on the website, say your website, websites shouldn't cost £6,000. They should cost £400 minimum, like cheapest. And I think one of the things that I wanted to highlight today was the British Bangladeshi restaurateurs, sometimes they think they need to buy a marketing software and they don't necessarily need it, and they don't know what the average cost is, and they sometimes overspend. So a website, if they have a basic website, but they have an option where they can update some content, the content being, say it's Christmas, and they can say, did you know we're doing Indian style Christmas roast or something? Because they've put lots of different content on their website, that also increases their Google rank. And so when someone looks for their website, for them as a restaurant or a restaurant in Surrey, they're going to go up in the Google ranks because every week or month or so, they're putting new information that isn't repeat information from their pages onto their website. So if you go on social media and you put, oh, how to make chicken tikka, or did you know actually Bengalis produce mithai, it's interesting information. It's something for people to talk about, which, that was, you know, maybe they sit to their friend and their friend will say, well, how do you know that? Well, actually, I saw it on that website. I saw it on that restaurant's Facebook.
Thank you. Viewers, I'm going to ask you to phone call me. For the after, if you phone call, then I'm going to ask you to phone call. For the after, phone call me. Let me go and see a video and we'll all share and come back to you. Viewers, let's go and see a video clip. The restaurant of Killer Tomorrow actually marketing career profit. Let's see this.
PR, marketing, and branding to increase your restaurant's revenue. Create an engaging social media presence. Easily communicate and interact with your customers. Increase your restaurant's exposure and tap into a new customer base. Quickly announce specials and promotions. Make a push to sell more gift cards. 16% of gift cards purchased do not get redeemed. Cater to the economically minded. Run lunch and dinner specials. Increase profitability through menu changes. Restaurant operations must stay up to date with trends and commodity demands. Adjust menu offerings accordingly. When commodity demand soar, you can expand your menu. Example, with the public being more health conscious, add healthy water-based soups to your menu. Water is a low-cost commodity. You will be able to keep your soup cheap while catering to your customers' needs. Rewrite your menu item descriptions. Your menu is a selling tool. Before we see the food, the description needs to paint a vivid picture. Menu writing is copywriting in a niche form. It needs to be done by a creative and skilled writer. Establish a loyalty program. A loyalty program brings back regular customers and attracts new customers. The result is increased revenue. Loyal customers spend 67% more than new ones. Don't forget, PR, marketing, and branding is the way to increase your restaurant's revenue.
Viewers, welcome back. After the documentary clip, so let's go and see Nadia from Lagi Khara Liaison. Let's hand over to Nadia.
Thank you so much, and thank you to everyone that's been emailing in. Do keep those emails coming in. If we don't read them today, we will definitely read them out on the next show at A Catering Circle on Twitter. And of course, you can email us, cateringcircle@chsuk.tv. Our next special guest is Suhail Ahmed Rahman, who is a restaurant owner. My question to you, I mean, they're going heavy today on online and social media marketing.
So much. I've become an expert just listening to
you. Yeah, right. I know. I didn't realize how powerful it was. So my question to you is, how do you cater for your customers with regards to online social media or using your website, etc.?
Okay. Well, firstly, I'm actually the third generation of our business. When I first came to the business, my father had already set up a website in 1996.
Wow.
So I'd already found a website. I was very lucky to have a website there. Now, but the thing I've done with the website is I've made it usable, because it was just a very static website with an address, with a telephone number, just a couple of pages. But now what's happened is websites, they work for the business. You have to kind of give the customer some kind of call to action. So what we're doing is we're using our website to sell ourselves as much as we can. We have an online booking form. We have a facility where a customer can go online and order a takeaway. There's a gift shop there. They can buy Tower Tandoori merchandise. Not only is the website working for us in that way, just before we've made the website, we've optimized our website to the fullest. So, for example, if you search Indian restaurant London Bridge or SE1 or Bermondsey or something like that, we will most likely come up on the first couple of pages. And the reason why we have to do that is because it's all about search engine optimization nowadays. And the problem is, well, not the problem, but the thing is, when a customer goes out, they are going on Yahoo or they're going on Google and they're searching for an Indian restaurant in the local area, and we have to try our best to be at the top.
Like Sharina mentioned.
And there's all these technical things that if you read up on Wikipedia or even on Google that you find.
Or about go to a great marketing agency or PR agent.
Or go to a PR agent or go to a marketing agency. But there's things to do like with meta tags. So when you're building your website, there's kind of the coding inside the website that is really going to help you in the future. That's one thing about websites that we're doing. Not only are we using search engine optimization, we're also using pay-per-click. We're using email marketing. We're managing our reputation online via TripAdvisor and Google+. We're using social media to its fullest. You know, we have a mantra at our business. We say a tweet a day goes a long, long way. And we're using Instagram and Snapchat and LinkedIn and everything we can possibly. It's free. Yeah. And it's doing something good for your business, so why not?
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Suhail Ahmed Rahman. Thank you very much. And of course, for those of you watching at home, don't forget, send those emails in. Tweet us at Catering Circle. I'm going to pass it on to the panel. But before I do, we've had a really nice email in, actually. And this was for you. So it's saying, "Dear Mahi, I think you should consider this quote that I use all the time. And this is my mantra when it comes to marketing, PR and branding. It's not about counting people you are reaching. It's about reaching the people that count." Back to you.
Right, Helen, what would you say on today's subject to our viewers, PR, marketing and branding?
I say it makes sense to bring in a third party because they can take a long, objective look at what you're doing. It's sometimes very difficult when you're immersed in the day-to-day as a restaurateur, as a chef, serving your customers, to actually be able to see clearly the strategy forward and the messages that you want to put out to the press and to your community. So PR can take an objective look at what you're doing and help you develop key messages on your behalf, because sometimes you're just too close to it when you're working in the business.
Thank you. By Afrikita Ghiba, 30 seconds after Dilam.
আমি ওখানে কইমু আপনার বাঙালি দিয়ে শেষ করমু যে জায়গাত রেস্টুরেন্টে যখন মোস্টলি বেঙ্গলি দেন আপনারা বর্তমানে যে টুলস আছে লাইক ডিজিটাল মার্কেটিং শেফ অনলাইন পার্পল আই ইউজ দেম টু ইয়োর অ্যাডভান্টেজ বিকজ দে উইল টেক ইউ আ লং ওয়ে দ্যাটস
থ্যাংক ইউ
আই উড লাইক টু ফিনিশ
ইট বাই হোয়াট উড ইউ সে
টু সরি ওয়াজ
টু দিস সাবজেক্ট হোয়াট উড ইউ সে
আই মিন আই উড রিকমেন্ড অল দ্য রেস্টুরেন্ট ওনার্স টু get involved heavily on branding. I mean, I've worked with a lot of restaurant owners. A lot of you guys might have heard of a company called Just Eat. I was one of the early days co-founder of that company. And at the time when we've started Just Eat back in 2006, 2007, not many restaurant owners knew us, who we was. But we've had to go in there and educate them on what our platform's about, how we can get them more customers. And today it's one of the
leading
one on the market. So yeah, so this is where I've created Vada Creative for a lot of we work with a lot of high-end restaurant owners, so
Thank
we want to work with them.
What would you say?
I would say the customer comes first. The customer, understand your customer, and then you'll understand how to shape your menu, how to change your atmosphere, your decor. You'll understand what type of PR you want. You will understand which digital tools to use. And if you don't know, because a lot of people don't have digital skills, then go to your local evening college. They have digital classes for like £5. Understand how to do the basics, and then you can save some money.
Thank you. ভিউসকল আমরা আসলে সময় শেষ হওয়ার পথে আইসি যদিও আরও অনেক সময় আপনার লোকে শেয়ার করার ইচ্ছা আছে আমরা সবর বাট আমরা পারতাম না আমি এবং আমার গেস্টের পক্ষ থেকে যদি কোনো উপকার ভুল ত্রুটি হয়ে থাকে আসতে পারেন আপনার সবাই আমরা সবরে ক্ষমার চুকে আপনারা দেখবা সেকেন্ড জিনিস হলো আজকে প্রোগ্রাম বা আগামী দিনের প্রোগ্রাম আমরা যখন করি আপনারা আসলে এডুকেট করা লাগে প্রোগ্রাম না আপনার লোকে আমরা সবসময় শেয়ার করতাম যে আমরা ভিউস এবং আমরা যারা গেস্ট হলাম তারা ভিউ এর মানে নয় যে আমরা সবই রাইট আর আপনারা সব রং আপনারা এটা যেগুলো আপনারা শ্যুট করে এগুলো আপনারা যাচাই বাছাই করে দেখবা এবং তারপরে আপনারা এটা থেকে আপনারা এক্সিকিউট করবা যেটা আপনারা পছন্দ হয় সেটা আপনারা করবা আপনারা সব ভালো থাকবো আমার লাগে দোয়া করবো আমরা সবলাই দোয়া করবো আসসালামু আলাইকুম